Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my NCAA 14 updated rosters. New for the 2015 football season, Duke Blue Devils Dynasty. Yep, we started up another college dynasty because it's about time we got the updated rosters, and we're going ahead with week two here now of the Duke Dynasty. We're 1-0 after beating Marshall. We're doing a little recruiting, just showing you the board here. Some people that we have a shot with, some people we don't have a very good shot with, but we're kind of hanging on the board. Some people that might drop off the board soon if they cut us out of the race. Yeah, I don't know. We don't have a very top-heavy board as far as high overall players, but hey, we're Duke. We're working on this. We're trying to work on building some inroads with the recruits and building this thing up, and that starts with showing what we can do on the field and convincing these guys to come in. So this is just a look at what my board looks like right now. I've got a few more players than I'd like to on the board right now, 27, but this will thin out a little bit here as a few people most likely will lock us out, and then we'll move on from there. So I just wanted to show you where we stand in recruiting. It's been a long-standing thing for me saying that NCAA 14, I did not like the recruiting system as much as 13, but I do like the on-field play better in 14. So it's a trade-off. We are headed into the Big House today, Ann Arbor, Michigan, taking on the Michigan Wolverines and new coach Jim Harbaugh. Michigan down on their luck in recent years, but Jim Harbaugh trying to change all that, change the culture here in Michigan. And it's always one of the very toughest places to play, the Big House here, Ann Arbor, and 100,000 plus strong as Duke gets the ball first, and they're going to try to hang on to the Sean Wilson. A pretty nifty rush right there for 9 yards. It'll make it second and one where he's able to pick up a first down and more. And the Duke Blue Devils at least will hang on to the football for a little bit. But it's second and 15 after a sack, trying to set up a screen. Nope, they sniff that out, and he only gets a yard back. It's going to be third and long. If Thomas Cirque and the Blue Devils want to hang on to the football here, he's looking to throw. Yeah, that never had a chance. Basically throwing that away at the sidelines, and it's going to be time to punt. So here comes the Michigan offense. Check out Smith's numbers, 114 yards and a touchdown and 18 carries in the first game, and led them to a victory in week one. So here's some play action, and they're throwing to Jake Butt. Yes, get your laughs in there right now, Jake Butt. But he can catch football. Here we go with a handoff out of the shotgun, and there is Smith rattling off 11 yards and a first down. So Michigan moving the football. On their first possession, they might be sensing a mismatch here in the old line versus the Duke D line. Although there's a nice play. Yeah, he still gets the first down. Smith is injured. He's not getting up. Did get the first down just barely. And they move the chains, but he'll have to come off the field. Here's Green getting the handoff. And whoa, you see Duke players being shoved around there out front. Nice blocking as Derek Green picks up 13 yards. And Michigan looks like it's going to be hard to stop them on their way to the end zone here. Green again bowls forward for first and goal. They're going to have the football inside the five. Here's Smith back on the field, and he scores easily the four-yard touchdown run. And that was some domination right there as the Michigan O-line goes to work and digs in. And they win the battle of the trenches here against Duke. 7-0 Michigan. First quarter expiring. Thomas Cirque over the middle. That's going to be knocked down. It's three and out for Duke. Not what they wanted at all, to give the football back to Michigan when they've already established that they can move it. First and 10, and they hand off to Smith. Smith going to bounce outside and back inside, and they still haven't gotten him down. He's past midfield and gets a big first down and 21-yard gain. Oh, boy, this might get away from Duke in a hurry here if we're not careful. We got to be tackling, be fundamentally sound. Got to win some battles here on the line, or at least be blitzing to compensate. Here is a screen pass. Called it a good time because we had a blitz on, and that's going to be a big first down inside the 20. That's 24 yards in all as we brought safeties up the middle, and they countered it with the screen. Nice play call right there. Michigan getting everything right on offense so far as they once again move right on down the football field. Will Duke be able to come up with a play to keep him out of the end zone? Second and four. Smith to the left-hand side. He's going to be inside the five, down to about the two. It'll be first and goal. He's already got 60 yards rushing and a touchdown on first and goal. Can we get some penetration here and stop him? Smith fights his way into the end zone on the one-yard rush, and it's 14-0 Michigan. Man, two possessions and two scores. Looks like we're dealing with a monster today here in the Michigan Wolverines. Got to get something on this drive. Got to get going and at least down and get a field goal. How about starting with a third down conversion and they get that to Anthony Nash. 16 yards right down the hash. And we needed that. So they complete the pass on third and long. Able to keep this drive going. Second and seven. And there you go. You got a wide open tight end. Going to be short. All of the first down is Baylinson, but they will pick it up. Let's see where the spot is. Yes, Sean Wilson gets two. And they've got another first down on the drive. Very important that they hang on to the football and give their defense some rest. Reeves, the tight end, is going to be close to a first down. As a matter of fact, they give it to him at midfield. First and 10, Blue Devils. Once again, very important. Keep that defense off for a while. Let them get some oxygen there. That's going to be Schneider making a catch. And he's got 10 yards and a first down. Possession drive right here now for Duke. They encounter a third and one play. That's going to be a first down. And whoa, looked like a horse collar tackle right there or something. Not going to be called. But Sean Wilson does have 37 yards and, most importantly, got a first down. Play action. Cirque going to throw. Baylinson makes a catch. He'll get 8 yards. It'll be second and two as Duke is moving on in. Further in the red zone here. Hand off to Wilson. Wilson's going to get 2 yards, and it's a first down. First and goal. So Duke is answering back now on this drive. 50 seconds left before half. Screen pass. Wilson going to walk into the end zone on the left side. Great call right there. 5 yards and pay dirt for the score. Sean Wilson, a big part of that drive. And they definitely worked this thing down the field when they needed to answer and get the score, get on the board before halftime. 14-7 now. Michigan in the lead. Can they keep Michigan from going down the field? They don't really strike me as a two-minute offense, but let's see. Third and four. Ruddick wants to throw. Nice play closing on that. Jake Butt makes the catch, but he's going to be stopped. That's going to be halftime. 14-7 Michigan. So they score the first two scores here. Duke comes back with their own and feeling a little bit better about themselves, but Michigan gets the football to start the half. Ruddick wants to throw. Third and eight. That's short of the first down by 5 yards. Stopped by Duke. There you go. This should be power running here. That seemed to be working in the first half, but they get the ball back to Duke right away. Now you got Sean Wilson running for 5 yards. It'll be second and five. Cirque wants to throw this time. Thomas Cirque, no! He's going to be taken down. There are quite a few sacks for Michigan on the day today. Third and 12. Here's another one. It's at least three that Thomas Cirque has suffered so far. Fourth and 20, it'll be definitely time to punt, just not enough time to find an open receiver right there, and he pays the price. So Michigan maybe waking up on defense. They get the ball back, and they're in Duke territory. Look at the stiff arm. Great stiff arm, but he does not get the first down. Smith is stopped. That's great team defense. Fourth and inches. Michigan's going to go for it. Big call right here and a big play. Can they stuff this? Linebacker Humphreys gets in there. The ball's loose. Michigan falls on it, but it doesn't matter. It's going to be a turnover on downs. Ruddick, the quarterback, was able to recover this, and they actually reviewed this and said no fumble. His knee was down. Didn't matter. It's a turnover on downs. Here's a big run. Oh, and a big hit at the end there, but Sean Wilson gets 10 yards first. Wanted to do a spin move here. Never got it off. Really didn't have his balance. It'll be second and inches. They convert there later in the drive, third and six. Thomas Cirque going to step in. Wide open is Nash. Over the middle, inside the 10, to about the 7-yard line. It'll be first and goal. Anthony Nash for 39 yards. Here come the Blue Devils. Wilson up the middle, just short of a touchdown. It's going to be third and goal after that 5-yard rush. He's got 65 yards now. Third and goal. I formation. Wilson's going to barrel in there for the touchdown. Duke is an extra point away from tying the game on the road. The big house finally got much quieter now with these two consecutive Duke scores to tie things up. They thought it was going to be a rout. So the extra point is up, and it is no good. Wide left, what happened? It didn't feel like I missed that meter very much. Oh, man, that hurts. We're now down one when we thought we tied this thing up. And here goes Smith, not to be denied, first down and more. He picks up 14 yards. Michigan, oh, man, they know they dodged a bullet there. With a missed extra point, keeping them in the lead. Yep, here is Duke's defense trying to respond, though. They're going to force third and 10. Can they get pressure on Ruddick here? He's going to throw deep, one-on-one. Overthrows his man, and they're going to have to punt fourth and 10. Now with the ball back and down one because of the mixed extra point. Thomas Cirk wants to throw on 3rd and 12. Wide open man Reeves down the sideline. How'd they forget about him? He's a big tight end. How do you lose him? 41-yard reception, and it gets Duke into business right here on the Michigan end of the football field. Reeves left all alone on that play. Breakdown on the defense. And we got a 3rd and 11 here. Cirk is going to throw. He's picked off. No, he's picked off. Jumped the route right there. Thought he had his man. First turnover of the day by either team. Thomas Cirk thinks he has his man open, but nope. Drifting back there to pick that off. What a play by Lions on the defense. And now they got to get the ball back somehow. Oh, boy. Okay. Well, we're going to try to stifle him here. The pitch, 2nd and 8. Stiff arm. No, he's going down. He loses a yard. Stays in bounds. So Duke will call a timeout right here. And they will see what they can do. 3rd and 9. That pass is terrible. Looks like he's just kind of getting rid of that. Big play right there because it actually stops the clock for Duke without having to call a timeout. So they get the ball back here in 2:37 to play. McCaffrey makes a catch, takes a big hit, but does get a first down for the Blue Devils. That's his first catch, and it goes for 12 yards. Moving into Michigan territory. Handoff, and a pretty good run right there. 7 yards for Sean Wilson. It'll be 2nd and 3. Can Duke get into position? Remember, they missed an extra point. I don't know how they feel about a field goal, but obviously you'd like to have a chance to win this on a game-winning field goal. They get a first down there. 2nd and 6. Cirk over the middle. McCaffrey again. 3rd and inches after the 6-yard catch. Michigan actually takes a timeout right here on 3rd and inches. Trying to conserve time to possibly get the ball back. Fullback, which is actually the tight end, David Reeves. 5-yard rush and a first down. Huge right here. Michigan does not take a timeout. They're letting this tick down. And once again, after the Sean Wilson run, Michigan decides to hang on to their 2 timeouts, let it run down to 3 seconds, and Duke calls the timeout. Kicker is iced. Send back out here for the game winner. It is up, and it is good. The Duke Blue Devils stun the Michigan Wolverines on a last-second field goal and win in Ann Arbor 16-14. Duke improving to 2-0. Michigan falls to 1-1 on the last-second field goal, and you see the reaction right there. Game winner for the Blue Devils. That's what happens when you got a senior kicker. I guess he atones for his mistake earlier. I'm still not sure what went haywire on the extra point, but he makes up for it with the game-winning field goal. Thomas Cirk stayed in the ballgame this time, was not knocked out like he was in the first game. Did not need his backup to come in, and you see his numbers. Here's Sean Wilson up at 84 yards. Tough running at times, but he really stuck in there and got big plays when we needed it. And you see the receiving stats as well right there. In a huge win in Ann Arbor, they come in and take out the Big Ten foe, Michigan Wolverines. So that should help recruiting, getting a statement win like that. Yeah, no, they weren't ranked, but it was a big road win always in Ann Arbor. That is a tough thing to pull off. So you look at the top 25 by request. I will show this here whenever possible. You see, we are not in the top 25 after advancing to the next week, but maybe we'll get some consideration soon. If we continue to knock teams off like, oh, I don't know, number 13 Georgia Tech, that'd be a good place to start to try to crack the top 25. We'll see you next time for more Duke Blue Devils football. Thanks for joining me. Leave a like, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!